بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين اللهم يا حي يا قيوم يا ذا الجلال والإكرام اللهم إنا نسألك من فضلك العظيم اللهم إنا نسألك من خيري الدنيا والآخرة اللهم إنا نسألك نعيما لا ينفد وقرة عين لا تنقطع اللهم اغفر ذنوبنا واستر عيوبنا وارحم ضعفنا واجبر كسرنا يا رب العالمين We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect all of us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us Jannat al-Firdaus. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the best ending. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to Jannat al-Firdaus. My dear brothers and sisters, today is a Friday. Tonight is the night of Saturday. Today is September 30th, and which is the last Friday this month. And the topic will be, inshallah, regarding al-wasiya. Al-wasiya, which is the will that a Muslim has to do it before he or she dies. And al-wasiyah, it's important. Wasiyah, it is important. And before to start speaking about wasiyah, I would like to pass two things. First of all of you have phones. So if you do not have a pencil, pen and paper to write some information, write the information on your phone. Second, sisters, we need your help. Please keep the kids quiet who are beside you. And if some daughters do not listen, send them to me, please. Send them here. So let me start first about what's al-wasiyya. Al-wasiyya, it is something has to be written from the person that he believes that he's leaving this dunya. And he has to write some important things about himself or about his family. And al-wasiyya, two kinds. First kind is wajib, mandatory for every single Muslim who believe in Allah on the Day of Judgment, that he has to write that. Second, wasiyya, which is jaiz, that it's better for him to write that, but even if he did not write that, that's okay. He will not get sin. But the first one is wajib, and we will start with the first one. The first wasiyya, which is wajib, that a Muslim has to write everything belong to him or to some people that they need it from him. So the first one, as he has to write something belong to him, the first one in his wasiyya that he has to write and he has to start his wasiyyah as what Anas ibn Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu said on al-Sahaba, that he has to say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. His wasiyyah has to start with, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wa anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, وأن عيسى عبد الله ورسوله وكلمته ألقاها إلى مريم وروح منه، وأن الجنة حق وأن النار حق وأن النبيون حق وأن محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم حق وأن الساعة آتية لا ريب فيها وأن الله يبعث من في القبور. This long kalima you have to start your wasiya with. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمد رسول الله وأن عيسى عبد الله ورسوله وكلمته ألقاها إلى مريم وروح منه، وأشهد أن الجنة حق وأشهد أن النار حق وأشهد أن محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم حق وأشهد أن الساعة آتية لا ريب فيها وأن الله يبعث من في القبور. So you will say, I'll bear witness that there is no God in truth but Allah, and I bear witness that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. I bear witness that Isa is the messenger of Allah and his word. And I bear witness that al-Jannah is right and it is a truth. And I bear witness that al-Nar is a truth. And I bear witness that the day of judgment is coming for sure. And I bear witness with no doubt, and I bear witness that Allah subhanahu, that I will meet Allah and Allah azza wa jal will send people to the day of judgment. You have to start your wasiya with this statement. Then you say, amma ba'd, after this, I advise my family, starting with my wife, my children. You mention them, or you say all of my children, every single one that you are responsible in him. I advise you to worship Allah alone with no partner, and to follow Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and to stay always together and do not cut your rankship, do not cut your rahim, kinship. And I advise you to pray on time and to obey Allah and to stay away from anything that brings the wrath of Allah. If you leave Islam, or if you disobey Allah, I am free from you. You have to write that. And you have to write, do not die except in any way except in the way of Islam. Who did that? In the authentic hadith, the Prophet ﷺ and Anas ibn Malik say, who said that? Ibrahim alayhi salam. Allah said that in the Quran. وَوَصَّى بِهَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ بَنِيهِ وَيَعْقُوبُ يَا بَنِيَّ إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَى لَكُمُ الدِّينَ فَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. Allah said, وَوَصَّى بِهَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ وَوَصَّى بِهَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ بَنِيهِ وَيَعْقُوبُ. Ibrahim عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ and Yaqub عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ called his children before to die. And he said, oh my children, Allah has chosen you to be prophets and to worship him. So do not die except on the way of Islam. Do not die in any way except the way of Islam. And Allah said, أَمْ كُنْتُمْ شُهَدَاءَ إِذْ حَضَرَ يَعْقُوبَ الْمَوْتِ إِذْ قَالَ لِبَنِيهِ مَا تَعْبُدُونَ مِنْ بَعْدِي قَالُوا نَعْبُدُ إِلَهَكَ وَإِلَهَ آبَائِكَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْمَعِيلَ وَإِسْحَاقَ إِلَهَ وَاحِدَ وَنَحْنُ لَهُ مُسْلِمُونَ. Ya'qub alayhi salam, before to die, he called his children. And he said, when I leave you, who you will worship? They said, we will worship Allah, your Lord, your Ilah, your true God, and the Ilah of your parents. Means Ibrahim, the Ilah, the Lord of Ibrahim. And they mentioned, قَالُوا نَعْبُدُ إِلَٰهَكَ وَإِلَٰهَ آبَائِكَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْمَاعِيلَ وَإِسْحَاقَ إِلَٰهَ وَاحِدَ وَنَحْنُ لَهُ مُسْلِمُونَ. So they said, we will worship the God of Ibrahim and Ismail and Ishaq. And this is the true God. And this is the only true God. And we are Muslims. This is the first point of al-wasiya. To advise your family to die Muslims and to live as a Muslims. And to follow Allah and do not cut the relationship between all of them. You have to write that. Second point of your wasiya. If you have deen, if you have a loan, you have to write that. And you have to say that I have a loan and this amount I have to pay it to this person or to this bank or to this organization, whatever. And I didn't pay it yet and you have to pay it. You have to take it from my wealth and you have to pay it. Even if you don't have, your children will take care of your loan and will pay that to you. That is their responsibilities. Third point, if people owe you money or owe you some rights, let's say if you gave loan to some people and you need this money back to come to you, you write that and you say, this person and that person, he has to pay me whatever, the amount or whatever. So you have to write that, and you have to mention that this person has to pay you everything. You have to write that. If you do not write that, then in dunya you cannot blame anybody because Allah said faktubu, you have to write that. Come here. So this is the third one. The fourth, is coming about the most important thing about your children, and this is here in Canada or in non-Muslim countries. If you lift a children under 18 years, you have to write who will be responsible after you. If you passed away, of course, if your wife is still, or if the wife passed away, of course, her husband still, he will take care of that. But what about if you are only the person who is taking care of the children, or both of you passed away at the same time, an accident or whatever? So what do you have to do here? Your children, somebody will take them. By law here, the government will take them. And when the government will take them, the government will decide to who they have to give. your children. Doesn't matter the religion. There are some standard, they are looking for it, but it's not the religion. Your responsibility as a father and mother to keep your children Muslims. You have to riot. If I and my wife passed away, then this person, you write the name of the person that you trust, that he would be responsible on your children. You have to write, this person will take care of my children and he will be the guardian of my children after us. And you have to sign, and your wife has to sign. When you have no family in this country, the next point, you have to write, sorry, the next point is the point which is not wajib, which is the second kind of the wasiya. The second kind of wasiya, that if you want to do something, if you want to give sadaqah, or if you want to write something of your will, fi sabilillah, to give it to some orphans, to give it as a donation to poor people, orphans, to want to give somebody. The first one, the first condition of this wasiyah should not pass the third of your will. Only the third of your wealth, not more than that, because more than that, this is the right of your children, and even if you give less than the third, will be better. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told Abdul Rahman ibn Auf, when Abdul Rahman ibn Auf came to him and he said, oh Allah's messenger, I feel that I'm going to die, I'm going to give the whole of my wealth. And he was very rich man. في سبيل الله, he said. Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said, give only a sudus. Then he said, I want to give more, of Allah's messenger. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, no, give only third. Only the third of your wealth, and he said the third is too much. But if you want to give, just give a third and that's it, or less. And he told him the reason. You may live in this life for long and you will may have a children. Allah knows your future. So he told him, do not leave your children behind you, poor or they need money. And that's what happened to Abdul Rahman ibn Auf. He stayed after that time, long time after this speech with the Prophet ﷺ, he stayed for long life and he got married from another woman and Allah gave him children. And he said, Alhamdulillah, that Prophet ﷺ told me just keep the third of your wealth. And when Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu came and asked Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, O Allah, his messenger, I want to give the whole of my wealth. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, give al-khums. Al-khums means so when you 20% of what you have. So, Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, I will follow what Allah said and what his messenger said. Because Allah said, فَأَنَّ لِلَّهِ خُمُسَهُ
And he gave al-khums, 20% of his wealth, fi sabilillah, as a sadaqa jariya. The condition of this kind of sadaqa, of wasiya, you should not pass the third, and the second one, you should not give it to anyone has a right in your wealth, in your inheritance. As what? As a father or mother or son or daughter or wife. Do not write some people wrote for their children. Let's say you have 5 children. He wrote, I would like to give this child 20% because he was serving me more than the other kids, because he was obeying me more than the other kids. I want to give him 20%, 30%, 40%. This is haram. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, or Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sitting in masjid, a man came to him and he said, oh Allah's messenger, I want to make you a witness. He said, witness of what? He said, I would like to give my son some of my wealth. He told him, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, did you give all of your kids or all of your children same as what you gave to the son? He said, no. He said, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, go. I can't be witness on dhulm. This is dhulm. And he said the statement. He said, اتقوا الله وأعدلوا بين أبنائكم. Fear Allah and be just with your children. Doesn't matter if this one obey you and the other one, the one who's have a good relationship with you and the other one no. All of them same. You have to deal with them same, same stage. If you give one more, then you will come on the day of judgment as a zalim. The questions will be in the last 10 minutes, inshallah. We, after 5-10 minutes, we'll be finished, inshallah, this lecture. From al-wasiyya, after your deen, Allah said, مِن بَعْدِ وَصِيَّةٍ يُوصِي بِهَا أَوْ دَيْن. After your deen, you can write that I want to give 10% of my wealth, I want to give 10% of my wealth, I want to give this or that. But if you have a deen and you owe people money, you cannot give before to pay off your deen and your loan. And I will go back now to the most important thing. About al-wasiyah. Al-wasiyah on your children. How to make executor on them or guardian. And who is the person? The first point, the person is better to be from your family, but he has to be a trustee. That you trust him will not take their right, and you trust him, he will grow them up on the way of an Islam. If you don't have this person in your family, you have to hire somebody. And you have to go and ask him permission. And if he said yes, then he has to sign on that, to accept that, and you have to have a witness. And you have to have a 2 copies from al-wasiyya. One with you and one with him. You have to do it. If you do not do it, and if you pass away, and your children young, and somebody took their right, you will be responsible in the day of judgment because you didn't protect them. And Prophet Muhammad ﷺ said, مَا بَالُ امْرِئٍ يَبِيتُ لَيْلَةً أَوْ لَيْلَتَيْنِ إِلَّا وَوَصِيَّتُهُ مَكْتُوبَةٌ عِنْدَ رَأْسِهِ. Prophet ﷺ said, there is no mu'min sleeps night or tonight without his wasiyah that he wrote it and it has to be under his head. What he wants to say, you don't need to put it under your head, but it has to be in very secure place. If you do not try it that, then people, especially here, will use the law. And people will not follow the Islamic way. So that's why you have to write that. And I know so many of you here, they have a children and their children under 18. And they didn't write their wasiyah, and it has to be documented due to the lawyer. If you go to the lawyer, it will not take more than $100 or $200. Because it's ready, there's a draft. You need just to add that, to put the stamp and to sign. Now, what about yourself and al-wasiyah? You have to write in yourself that if I pass away, this is your right. You have to spend from my wealth on my janazah. People should not pay in my janazah. Except if you don't have. You have to put me in Muslim graveyard. I want a righteous person to wash my body. And sometimes it's better for you to write the person. If he passed away, then tell them any person. Righteous person. I want this person to pray janazah on me. To lead my janazah. If this person not here, then find the righteous person. I am free from my family if they disobey Allah in my janazah. If they start screaming or they don't accept that. They don't accept the decision of Allah. I'm free from that. I know one Muslim brother. He didn't write his wasiyah. You know what happened to him? They burned his body. And they sent his body to his family back home in a small cup. What's the left, you know, from the fire? Muslim brother. Muslim. I know another brother. I don't know him personally, but I know the people around him. His wife, non-Muslim. She burned his body. She gave permission. He's Muslim. Because of what? Because they don't want, she doesn't want to pay for his janazah. You have to write that. Today, you have your family with you. Alhamdulillah. But Allah knows when you are going to die and on which situation. Come here. Allah knows which land that you are going to die. And in which situation, Allah knows. So don't depend on the recent situation and say, okay, alhamdulillah, my kids around me, my family around me, and everything is okay. No. You have to protect yourself. You have to protect your children. And you have to write everything because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that. Now the point is, the person who said, I have nobody to hire him. I don't have anybody to hire him. It is better, brothers, to share that between yourselves. To help each other. I'll be your guardian and you will be my guardian. If I passed away before you, you will be responsible of my children. If you passed away before me, I will be responsible. I will be, okay, what about my children is, mashallah, over 18. Some of them, mashallah, over 40, 30. Okay, brother, my children have no idea about my janazah how to be. I will hire you to be responsible. I have to sign that. You are the responsible of my janazah. And I give you the authority from now to spend the money from my account before my family to do anything from my janazah. And same thing, I will do that for you. You have to do that. Some of my brothers have no idea. Some of my brothers, their children have no idea about anything. You go to janazah, you find that the women and the brothers and sisters do not follow the rules of a janazah. I personally attended Muslim janazah. They brought white birds, pigeons. And when they put the women inside the grave, they just let the pigeon fly. I said, why they do that? They said, because they want her nafs, her ruh, to fly in peace. See how shaitan is teaching them. I go and I attend janazas and I see brothers and sisters using black clothes. A sign of sadness. Who told you black color is a sign of sadness? Who told you that? Is it in Islam? Of course not. This is not our culture. This is not our religion. This is the religion of non-Muslims. I saw in janazas they bring the flowers. Muslims, they bring the flowers. This is not Muslim rules. Al-janazah has to be under Islamic rules. That's why you have to write somebody that you trust him. They have to bring janazah. After a janazah, immediately they have to take you to the graveyard. As soon as possible. And when they put you in the graveyard, your grave has to be following a sunnah. Your grave should not pass, the highest of your grave should not pass one hand like this, shibr. Prophet ﷺ said, do not make them build, spend thousands just to, wallahi, brother called me before just 2-3 days. He said, subhanAllah, for the granite and some stuff, he said they asked for 4,000 or 5,000. Is this Islam? No. Just you need a small thing to write the name of you. If not, Allah knows him. Just that's for you. If you want to visit him, you will recognize this is my son, this is my daughter, this is my wife, this is my husband, whatever. Family member. Something small to write, that's it. Some people, they put and they bring food on a janazah. It's not the Islamic way. Some people standing on a janazah and start reciting the Quran 10 times, 12 times, some surahs of the Quran. It's not the Islamic way. What happened? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he attended the janazah, and this is subhanAllah, so many authentic hadith, what he did? He was sitting and he recommended and he encouraged the Sahaba to make a dua, to say, Allahumma as'alu li akhikum al-thabat fa innahu la yus'al. Ask Allah to support your brother because the malaika will question him. So you say, Allahumma thabbithu inda su'al. Oh Allah, support him to answer the question. Oh Allah, forgive his bad deeds. A dua, that's it. What about reciting the Quran? The Quran is a beautiful and is the beautiful words of the Quran. But it's not that time to recite the Quran. Why? Because Prophet ﷺ did not recite the Quran there. He only made a dua. Ya Shaykh, why you say that? The Quran is beautiful. Okay, let's read the Quran while we are making a sujood there. Why we cannot read the Quran when we make a sujood? Because Prophet ﷺ was not doing that. And he said, a sujood only place of a dhikr and a dua. Then let's read Surah Al-Fatiha when we make a ruku' in a salah. The Quran is beautiful, better than a dhikr. No, why? Because Prophet ﷺ said, only Subhana Rabbi al-Azim 3 times. Follow a sunnah. And when you follow a sunnah, come here. Come sit beside your dad. Follow a sunnah, and you need to tell the person, maybe your son or your daughter, your wife cannot do that. I strongly advise you to give this point to the person that you trust. To write, this person has to be responsible in my janazah, and he has to pay everything with my janazah, and he is only the responsible, no one of you. Khalas. Even if your children, adults, Islamically, they have to go back. Even by law. If you write that, finish. And he will take in care of your janazah. Important, my dear ones. The person who is washing your body, not any person. He has to be a person that he fears Allah and he knows exactly how to wash the body. And he has to be a very secure person. Because sometimes the person who passed away, he will have some signs. And the person who is making the ghusl for him, he has to keep it in his heart. And he has not to tell anybody, even his family. No. Even if they ask you, do not give them any answer. So have you done that, brothers and sisters? If not, then you have to write that. Some of brothers have a bad aqidah. You know what's bad aqidah, bad faith? They say, I don't want to write that. Why I have to, if I write that, maybe I would die. They think that when he writes, you know, why you have to write that? I'm scared to do that. I don't want to do that. His aqidah, miskeen. If Allah made a decision that you will die today, you will die if you write or not. If Allah had a decision that you will die next year, if you write today or you write, if you do not write it, you will die next year. So al aqidah is al aqidah. This is al-wasiya. You have to write it. It's better to give it to your family. Nobody has to open that. But when you die, the person has to open that. And they have to open it before your janazah, once you passed away. They have to open and they have to read, because he will write in a janazah too. Who has to pray janazah on you? Who has to wash your body? And you have two witnesses on your wasiya. To grant your wasiya, because maybe your children will not practice that. One of the most important things, I advise you to do it. If you passed away in this country, let people around you or your wife or whoever to pray janazah here and to put you here in the graveyard, not to send you back. Home. Why? Because here in the hospital will not send you back before to take all the livers, kidneys and lungs, everything from your body. And Prophet ﷺ said, Al-Muslim has a right if he dies or if he's in life. No one has a right to take that. But this is the rules here. If they want to send you back to your family, to another country, they have to take everything. So that's why don't do it. But put the conditions that put me in Muslim graveyard, and also you have to pray janazah on me. You have to wash my body and keep this certain amount. This is my janazah. This is for my janazah. Nobody has to touch it. Before anything, because Allah said, "Min ba'di wasiyya," the errant, al-mirath, inheritance. The inheritance has to be after your wasiyya. When they open wasiyya, okay, he said he has loan, we have to pay it first. Then we have to pay his janazah, and we have to do this. Okay, now we finish his wasiyya. Then we have to give sadaqah from his wealth, let's say 10,000, 20, 50, whatever. Then okay, now the risk for us, let's divide that based on what Allah said. This is the rules, like this. Children fighting after their parents passed away for money, because there is no wasiyya, no will. Children having bad relationship because of fighting for a house. Small amount sometimes, 20,000, 10,000. They fight for that. He took the right of my mother, he took the right of my father. How much? 10,000. They fight, jahl. Why? Because the father or mother did not write the wasiyya. You have to do it. And you have to keep your children together. Wallahi, I still remember my father, may Allah have a mercy on him. He did it before he died, while he was in life. He said, now everything, it's mine. Nobody has to touch it. But if I passed away, this for that, this is for that brother, this house for those girls, this house for those girls, this house for this brother, this. And my father was, mashallah, very wealthy. So he distributed everything. When he passed away, we wouldn't think about anything of that. We don't even have any negotiations, nothing. Because he did that in front of everybody. This is for that, this is for that, this is for this, this for this, if I passed away. If not, everything still belong to me. We know that, khalas. Are you accepting that? We said, yes, khalas. Why you talk about that? Why? But after that, we made dua for him. Because we saw relatives fighting. Police came. Imam is trying to resolve the problems. Why? Because the father did not write al-wasiyya. Al-wasiyya is important. Even to protect your young children from the old children. To protect your daughters from your sons. To protect your children from your brother. So many stories. This is regarding just inheritance. What about the religion? Nobody will take care of the religion if you do not take care of that. So that's why write your wasiya. Write your wasiya for you and your family. This was my message today. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to benefit every single one from this lecture. Brothers and sisters, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of you. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather you with your parents and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Jannat al-Firdaus. I will open 5 minutes before we pray for the question. Still, we still have 9 minutes, I think. Right? Yes, sir. Okay, 9 minutes.